keep them going. Thick wheels rolling, moving on. The white line is the lifeline to a nation. And men like Will and Sonny make it move. A good hot cup of coffee is waiting up ahead. And the rhythm of the highway hums along. Jamming gears has got to be a fever. Cause men become addicted to the grind. It takes a special breed to be a truck driving man. And a steady hand to pull that load behind. Big wheels rolling, gotta keep them going. Big wheels rolling, moving on.
Don't ever wake me up when I'm sleeping, okay?
Yeah, listen, they set up a DOT check right in this rest area.
Which rest area?
This rest area, Vapor Lock. Smokey must have given them a shout as to who was coming through. They say we're over length. Come
Look,
on now.
Just go away, huh?
Shake the cobwebs loose and wake up, will you? Come on.
Did you run the
whole... Yeah, I bumped the tires. I ran through the lights and the butterflies. I showed them the manifest, the log, the registration, and they still want to talk to you.
Did you slide the fifth wheel?
They wouldn't let me. They said I should have slid it before. Come on, let's go.
All right.
Get your boots on, let's get out of here.
You Pruitt?
Yeah, let me see your driver's license.
Where you going?
Come on. Mr. Pruitt. Your truck's over length for the state.
Matter of fact, your total axle length exceeds North Carolina regulations by almost 18 inches. You know that?
Yeah, well, see, we're running empty, and I usually have that wheel pushed forward, but we jammed it all the way back to make it easier to run over that section of road that they haven't finished outside of...
Coming out of Roanoke.
Yeah, we just forgot to push it forward.
All right. Open up your trailer. I want to see it. Open it up.
What for?
You said you was running empty.
So?
So I want to check it out. Mr. Pruitt. You know I could fine you for that overlength, don't you?
Yes, sir.
Matter of fact, I just fined the fellow one just a few minutes ago here. Gave me the same bull you guys are giving me. Same thing. Had a rig just exactly like yours.
Fining him must have made your day.
Only thing about that rig that was like ours was the color.
Mr. Pruitt, it's too hot out here for me to be messing with you boys now. Open up that trailer, because I want to see what's inside there. That trailer's empty.
That's very sharp.
Mr. Pruitt, look at him. I'm just trying to do my job. You understand that?
Yes, sir, I know.
Mr. Pruitt, you look at me when I'm talking to you. I'm going to tell you something. I'm going to let you go. I ain't going to find you boys this time. Because you didn't tell me no lie.
Thank you.
But I'll guarantee you one thing. Next time you come through here, you better have that fifth wheel move forward. Or I'm going to tear your butt up.
Can I have my logbook back?
There's a living example of why this country's got a $60 billion deficit.
Can I go back to bed now?
No. You just went on the clock. Sorry, guy.
We're only a couple hours out of Charlotte. If we meet the day drivers in there, we can have a load out of there by this afternoon.
Better not try beating anybody. Smoky all over the place.
We can go to that truck stop on I-85, see what we can do out of there.
That bumper sticker back there?
No, what?
Will the last trucker to leave Charlotte please turn out the lights?
That's supposed to be funny.
Supposed to mean that things are tight in Charlotte.
I know what it's supposed to mean, college boy.
Might not be too easy getting a load out of there. There's no work for the locals. Why should there be any work for us?
Look, I know Charlotte. It's loaded with textiles and gorgeous gals. And we'll make out both ways.
I don't know. Might be just as wise to head from Memphis.
No way, man. I've never let a town beat me yet. Some biscuits, milk gravy, brains and eggs, grits and pork chops.
That sounds good. What do they got for food?
Exactly what are grits?
Grits are just grits.
Is that why they call them grits? I mean, what's in them?
Look, you don't have to know what they are. Just try them. See if you like them.
There are a heap of truckers in here, boy.
Looks like a convention.
An unemployment convention.
That's the cutest thing I ever saw.
Well, hi, honey.
Where's my daddy?
Well, I don't know. Any of you fellas missing a daughter?
I woke up and he wasn't there.
Well, I'm sure he must be here someplace. What kind of game are you two playing with this little girl?
I beg your pardon?
You heard me.
No, ma'am.
You prove it?
Yeah.
That's your Kenworth out there?
Yeah, it's mine.
It's the rig she got out of. I saw it with my own eyes.
Well, you ought to be ashamed of yourself. Now, there you are, honey. Now, Daddy will look at me.
You're not my daddy.
Well, I know that.
I'm hungry.
Oh, well, maybe we better want a piece of pie, a glass of milk, something?
No, I like some eggs, pancakes, bacon, a big glass of milk, and ice cream.
No grits?
That gives me gas.
Oh, I see.
No mistake. She got out of the rig.
She couldn't have.
Well, she must have gotten in back at the rest area. That's the only
possibility. That's 100 miles back.
Little girl? What's your name?
Charlie.
Charlie what?
Just Charlie.
Oh, come on. You got two names.
Hey, Pruitt, lighten up. It's not your ex. It's a little girl. Charlie, does your daddy drive a truck?
No, I don't need my daddy says I get nasty.
Look, just leave it up to me, will you? I know how to handle kids. All right, now, kid, tell me, where's your daddy?
Oh, good. You're a regular Pied Piper.
Okay, wise guy, what do you want to try?
Well, I'm going to get on the phone and see if I can find out something about her daddy, huh? Don't you worry. I'm going to find your dad.
Oh, yeah, right. You hold on to this.
I wouldn't leave you sitting here with that nasty man. Mm-mm.
You're the guy who wouldn't try the grits, huh?
Pruitt?
Yeah.
It's a nice-looking rig you get out there. Don't see too many of them big wheelbase tractors east of the river.
So?
Name's Norm Edney. This here's Junior Hobbs.
Junior.
Y'all looking for a load?
Isn't everybody?
Well, they're all looking. Only the lucky ones are making it.
And I have a feeling I'm about to get lucky.
Now, you see, the union ain't too strong hereabouts. Independents moving in all the time, looking to make a killing. Union can't do anything about it. Know why?
No, why?
Because I got this town all sewed up, that's why. Ain't that right, Junior?
Is that right, Junior?
Yes, sir, I'm the independent's friend, Pruitt. Say, you licensed to run the 48?
Yeah, I managed to get to most of them in a year.
You ever haul a tanker, hazard loads?
Well, there are no loads I don't know.
Look around you, Pruitt. There must be 200 trucks through here in a day.
Works real slow.
So what else is new?
Hey, wait a second, cousin.
Man's got to give a little, get a little.
How you figuring on getting out of Charlotte?
We got a legitimate broker. We'll manage.
Nick Wolf, he's out of commission right now for being uncooperative.
We could put you under a tanker tonight, Pruitt. Houston, top dollar. What about it?
How much?
Half a rock a mile, 38 cents a mile. If you got a deadhead to Mobile for another.
And how much for you?
Half, first load.
50%. I tell you what, you guarantee me 5 loads, I'll give you 10% each load. That way you get your 50. Put your name on a legitimate broker's contract. I need some kind of a guarantee.
Guarantee?
You won't even be back to Charlotte 5 times this year, Pruitt.
Okay, pay me 55 cents a mile, 38 to deadhead. I'll be back.
I think you're missing the point, Pruitt. We don't need you, you need us. Tell you what, you want some work, why? We all look us up. We'll be around. Meantime.
Well, I talked to Smokey. He's going to check the rest area. That's the best he can do.
I'm hungry.
What about Charlie's order, Uncle Sonny?
I'm sorry, Charlie. I got to talking to some guys. I'll get it right now. Rosie! In the meantime, Uncle Will, what happens to Charlie while everybody's out looking for the father?
What happens to Charlie?
Well, I guess we got a new partner.
Partner?
Officer, did you check the reports from all the other counties? I mean, you must have something about a missing child. No, just Charlie. Maybe his name is Charlie.
Can't let her wander around all day in her nightgown. What do you got?
Don't reckon you can. Well, how about this here T-shirt?
Yeah, okay. How about some pants?
Don't sell no pants.
How about jeans?
Jeans is pants.
Well, you got any skirts or shorts, dresses?
Listen, why don't you go right into town? You can get everything you want there. There's department stores all over Trade and Tryon Streets and shopping centers.
Well, I guess that's what we better do.
I sure like that T-shirt.
Do, huh? Well, give me one of those. Make it a large. And a piece of that red ribbon.
It's gonna be too big.
Just tell me how much, Rosie.
$2 even.
Come on, sugar.
Okay. Okay, you got my number.
Nothing. Nothing about a missing KID.
That spells kid.
As you get older, Charlie, you'll learn that little girls do better when they're not smarter than the men.
Sis.
Oh, I bought her a dress.
That's a T-shirt.
After she gets through with her shower, it'll be a dress, you see.
She's not wearing that.
Well, who says so?
I say so.
Please, Uncle Will.
Okay, honey. This overgrown KID is going to take you to the showers.
Take her to the men's showers?
This ain't the YWCA.
I'm not taking a little girl to the men's showers.
You want to put her through the truck wash?
My daddy takes me to the showers.
See? Her daddy takes her to the showers.
You take
her. No, you take her. I gotta go hustle up some work.
So what, you said you're gonna make a deal with the Toothpick Brothers?
Yes. Just...
You give them back this piece of rope.
I'm just gonna talk to them and see what kind of a deal I can work out.
You'll be bucking the locals.
Look, if the locals can't take care of themselves, that's their problem.
Oh, Pruitt.
Well, look, just take care of the house mating, huh? I'll go get us a job.
Are you gonna take me to the showers, Uncle Will?
Four years old, huh? Excuse me, this little girl, she wants to change, and
I'll get her cleaned up and put some...
Don't just stand there like a dying calf in a hailstorm. Bring her on in.
Well, you think you could just go outside?
Oh, I got all the time in the world. There's two stalls in here anyhow.
Yeah, but I don't want you to be...
Come on, mister. What do you take me for? That young'un can't be more than 4 years old.
Yeah, well, just watch what you're saying to yourself. Okay, Charlie.
Charlie? Did you say Charlie? I know a trucker's kid named Charlie. Let me look at you, honey. Are you Joe Sawyer's kid? The one they call the Mountain Man?
You're a tombstone. You owe my daddy $5. He said so.
That's her. That's Charlie. Hey, mister. What are you doing with Joe Sawyer's kid anyhow?
She's lost. You know where I can find her mom and dad?
Well, Joe's out on the road. I don't rightly guess I do. I was with him last week, and he had to take his wife to a hospital in an ambulance. That much I do know. Hey, you got a cigarette on you?
Cigar.
Well, that'll do.
Yeah, I understand, Danny. Okay, maybe next time. Listen, if anything comes up, give me a call here or give me a shout on the CB, huh? Okay, thanks, pal.
Having problems, cousin?
Nothing I can't handle.
Why don't you make it easy on yourself? I mean, you ain't gonna get no load out of Charlotte without it's got my name on it.
You're crowding me, isn't he?
50% of the load I get you is better than 100% of the load you're gonna get for yourself.
I'm not buying what you're selling. So why don't you get off my back?
Ooh, hey, we got us a hard case here, Junior. You a hard case, Pruitt?
Only when I'm pushed.
We get them all the time.
Maybe we should mash him a little, huh, Mr. Ed?
Maybe every truck in that joint will be all over you, too.
You believe that, you dumber than I thought. There ain't a guy in there to lift a finger to help you.
You know why? Because around here, they do what I tell them to do. No one see? Hey, you. Come here. Go give me some change. That's the kind of guy that's going to help you tangle with me. Hard case?
I don't need any help for you.
This one just don't believe, Junior. Think he needs some converting.
You come near me, gorilla, and I'm gonna stick this weasel right down your throat.
All right, all right. Forget it, Junior. He'll come around. They all do.
Where'd Edney go?
Back under his rock.
Hey, Pruitt, you better cool
it. Oh, come on, what's with you guys? Getting pushed around by a couple of hoods.
But you just don't know how things are around
That's
here.
What you think, friend.
Sorry, you can't.
Hey,
come
it's
in
me.
Here.
Oh, Jason, where are you? Isn't she ready yet?
No, she's been in the bathroom.
What are we whispering for?
I don't know. Oh, I don't know. Listen, come on over here. I want you to meet Tombstone. She's a friend of Charlie's father, Joe Sawyer.
Hey, great.
Well.
Hi. My partner says you know Charlie's father.
Yeah, I do. Me and him used to haul process together out of that Carolina Coast refinery. Of course, as for, had my tractor repoed. As far as I know, the old Joe's still doing it.
You know where he lives?
Yeah, some little old mountain town east of Knoxville.
You know the name of his broker, I'll call him.
His name's Wolf, but it won't do you no good to call him. He got put out of business yesterday.
Yeah, so we heard.
I guess you heard about Ed and his goons, huh?
Oh, yeah, but their bark is worse than their bite.
Yeah, well, they bite hard enough for me, my friend.
They do that to you?
They caught me running the load that didn't set up.
Why don't you guys just throw them out on their ears?
That sounds like a good idea, don't it? But you just passing through. We got to live here all year round.
I think that would make it more important than ever.
Well, like I said, you're just passing through.
Yeah, and it can't be too soon for me.
I'm ready for my shower.
Okay, Charlie. Just go on and take your shower.
She can't take a shower with her nightgown on. Go help her.
I brought her in here, but I'm not gonna wash her.
I am not gonna wash her.
I can wash my own self.
Now, what about Joe Sawyer?
Well, he needed a quick buck, what with his wife being in the hospital and all, so he snuck a bandit load out the back door.
So now he's got to hide out from the goons.
You said that right, son, because if they catch up with him, they're going to bust him up real good. So you hold on that little girl of his real tight, you hear?
Yeah, you bet.
Well, another thing, too, if Joe thinks that Ed and his goons has got a hold of that child of his, he's going to come hunting her, and then somebody's going to really get hurt.
Don't worry, nobody's gonna even touch her.
Mister, I don't ever worry. Life's just too short for her.
Wonder how she's doing.
Charlie, you wanna dry off now?
Somebody wash my hair. I can't do it by myself.
You heard the lady.
Yeah. So did you.
You have got to be the most helpless man I have ever run into. All right, Charlie. Uncle Sonny will wash your hair, and we'll clean you up like a new penny. Helpless. I just may become a dress designer.
Hey, Pruitt! Sonny Pruitt!
Yeah, Tombstone?
Telephone.
Okay, go with Uncle Will, huh? Be right back. Sonny Pruitt. Oh, yeah. Hi, Denny. What do you got? Yeah, just a minute. Yeah, I know where that is. Yeah, Houston, huh? That's great, man. Beautiful. Bye.
He's got something going for him, Junior. Stay with him. See what he's up to.
Yeah, well, that's why you made a mistake and got in the wrong truck, huh?
Hey, Will, we got a load. Danny Bryce called back. We can take a load of textiles to Houston and be out of here tonight.
Great.
But don't sound so enthusiastic.
Aren't you forgetting a little something?
Yeah, the KID.
Are very nice people that we're taking you to, Sugar. They'll take real good care of you until your daddy comes for you.
Come on, Charlie.
You promised.
What did I promise?
Yeah, Mouth. What did you promise?
You promised me that you get my own dress and my own kitty.
You're an ogre.
Look, I don't like this any better than you do, but we came in town to get a load, and we got a load. And we got a load without having to pay those sharks.
I'm listening, but I don't hear a word you're saying.
You want a split lip? You go ahead and try.
What's a split lip?
You're doing?
I made up my mind.
You're really serious about this, aren't you?
Look, it's only till Joe Sawyer comes to pick her up.
What if Joe Sawyer doesn't pick her up?
I don't want to go.
See?
What do you mean, what if Joe Sawyer doesn't come to pick her up? It's his daughter, ain't it?
For a lousy load of textiles.
Hey, guy, that's what we do, remember? That's how we make a living, or have you forgotten that?
All right, but I'm staying here, and I'm not going to be part of a child desertion.
Child desertion. It'll be all right.
It's sprinkling.
Gotta find out where Juvenile is.
Please don't leave me, Uncle Sonny.
Look, Charlie, you're going to be fine. They'll assign you to a nice lady who'll see that you get some sleep and... Look, Charlie, you're a little girl.
And I'm a trucker. I don't know how to take care of little girls. Will doesn't know how to... You can't keep eating ice cream for breakfast.
I love you, Uncle Sonny.
You like your dress?
I love it.
Okay. Don't get mustard on it.
I don't like any seconds again.
Look, gasless.
Isn't Uncle Will going to eat with us?
No, Uncle Will's out looking for a kitten.
How about you?
I am looking for a kitten. I'm just looking in the paper. Would you settle for an orangutan or a baby lion?
I would like an orange lion or a kitten.
I can't find any kittens. I got white mice, I got snakes, I got turtles, or I got rabbits.
I just want a kitten.
Okay. If Charlie wants a kitten, Charlie gets a kitten. Eat. You're welcome. How's she doing?
I think she's really out.
I'm not surprised. 3 animal shelters, 4 pet shops before she found what she wanted. I'll tell you one thing. I couldn't tell any of those kittens apart.
Well, she could. I wonder if her dad's shown up yet.
Yes, I hope he plays it cool. Those hoods are really going to be looking for him. You know, he's the only driver around here to take a load without their name on it.
He's okay in my book.
Yeah, mine too, but... What good is... What's his name gonna be to what's her name if he gets his head busted open? Hey, you wanna eat?
Yeah, you bet.
Me too.
Again?
Bottomless pit.
Checked in with the dispatcher.
Any of the guys talk to him on a CB?
No. Number one.
Last disappeared.
Oh, house guests. Gentlemen? Good girl?
I don't like you. My dad says you're nasty.
Well, me and him's going to have words about that when I meet him. In the meantime, it's you I want to talk to, cousin.
I'm eating.
Yeah, well, it'll wait.
No, it won't. The food here's bad enough when it's hot. When it's cold, it'd gag a buzzard.
I understand you made a little visit to the police.
What about it?
Well, excuse me.
A hard case, huh?
You better believe it, cousin.
It's all right. Believe it, Junior. We'll talk later.
What's my appetite?
Can I have it, Uncle Will?
Come on, you've eaten enough for a full-grown man already. It's time for you to take a nap. I'll take out the sleeper. Ready, set, go, boy.
God bless Mommy and Daddy and Uncle Will and Sonny. Amen.
Okay, hop in there, babe. Now, if you need anything, you just toot that tooter. You know where it is, right?
Right.
Oh, thanks, guy.
Got it all tucked in?
Yeah, snug as a bug in a rug.
Sugar, come see what Mama's got for you. Come on, Sugar. Come to Mama.
This crazy dog, I got her at a swap meet in Albuquerque. Pretty good deal. She came complete with collar and, you know, 2 months supply of dog chow. If you guys ain't got a beer for me, I'm going to report you to the management.
He just brought out two.
You know, I thought for a minute there I knew you. But my eyes are going, along with my good looks. Bought me a perfectly good pair of specs in Salt Lake City on State Street about 2 weeks ago. Already can't remember where I put them. You ever been on State Street in Salt Lake?
Yep, sure have.
Well, they got a pretty good dentist there. If you ever need to get your teeth fixed.
Okay.
Folks call me Henny.
Johnny Pruitt.
Will Chandler.
Isla. Come on out and meet our friends and bring us a six-pack. We're from San Bernardino. We got this camper at a plant where our son Joe works. Had it modified to fit our truck. Yeah, you're kind of cute in an arrogant sort of way. Man, you're some kind of a bull. Wow.
No word.
Aleph! Where's that six-pack?
No, I'll work on this for a while, thank you.
Fine.
Okay, just bring two cans, Aleph. His hearing's going bad. We don't have air conditioning. Has to drive with the windows open all the time, you know. Sugar. Pesky dog. I don't know why I worry about her. Dog's life is sure better than mine.
Howdy.
Oh, hi. Sonny Pruitt.
Hi there.
Will Chandler.
Nice looking rig you got here.
Thank you.
Contract or independent?
Indy.
Empty?
Yeah, we had to cancel a load. Previous commitments.
Look at me. Nobody's twisting your arm.
Don't see too many VITs like this east of the river. Too much restrictions here. Not much work either.
Shoot, you know, 2 years ago, we were averaging 3 loads a week at $300 a load. Now we're lucky if we get 2, and it costs a lot more to operate.
I know what you're talking about. We're having trouble just getting a load out of here.
Sounds kind of like you've been running up against them two creeps, huh?
Uh-huh.
That we did. You know, there's only one way to handle guys like that.
Well, you sure look like the kind of man that could do it, big man. Want to buy me another beer?
That's the deal. Come on.
What about Charlie, Uncle Sonny?
Oh, I locked it up. She'll be all right.
Hey, Sugar. Sugar, come on. I don't know. If that dog gets on by herself, she's an engine. What the heck?
Sit you down there, gal. Hey,
guy. Hi there, fellas. Hey, listen, I just got a call from Joe. Joe saw him? Says he's coming in. He'll be here later.
Does he know Eddie's laying for him?
Yes, sir, he knows. He says to heck with it. He's coming in anyhow. Hi there, Henry.
Hey, Tombstone. You looking hungry?
Oh, darling, ain't we all?
Well, at least he knows his little girl's okay.
Yeah, comes a downstairs maid.
Yeah.
Mr. Eddie is waiting to talk to you two.
Well, he'll keep.
He's a little upset about you going to the police.
Oh, you're breaking my heart. Beat it. Take care of this. Well, we might as well. We're not going to have any peace. All right. Tell Mr. Edney that we will be glad to speak to him.
At his earliest convenience.
Over here.
Over here.
Well, now,
care to sit down. You want anything?
Not me, thanks. You?
No, thanks.
What'd you tell the fuzz? Well?
I think Mr. Edney wouldn't like to know what we said to the police.
Yeah, I didn't get that impression.
Think we ought to tell him?
I don't know. You're the boss.
No, yeah, but you're the partner. We always decide these things together.
Yeah.
What?
Miss?
Wow.
Clam chowder.
Yeah, let me see.
I think.
Is that a large bowl or a small?
Large.
Large? $1.
$1.
Yeah. There you go.
$1. And $1 for the cleanup. Yeah.
Cleaning up what?
Yeah.
Oh, right.
Here you are, my man.
Oh, yeah.
You're dead, cousin. Both of you.
That's not bad chowder.
That's the best laugh I've had all year. I wished I'd done that.
Why didn't you?
Well, here's one good reason.
There's two of them. A whole bunch of you.
Add in all the truckers that cruise through this place in a day, there must be 2,000 of you.
Well, it's all very well and good for you to say, friend, but you see, we're kind of separate-like.
So stop being separate-like.
Well, how do we go about doing that?
You got a union. Why don't you start there?
Come on, you two beautiful men. You promised to buy me a beer.
Right.
I'm going into town to pick up some help. By the time I get back, I want that rig of theirs gone, you hear?
Something special you want done to it?
Yeah. Drive it out of town and dump it in the Catawba River.
We're not going to be able to take that load after all, Danny. Something's come up. But we'll keep in touch, okay? Right. You got a quarter?
Hey, why?
Hey, who does some kind of a lullaby?
Joe Brahms.
Well, it's not on here.
He doesn't write country and western.
Oh.
Sonny.
Oh, you sure did, Sugar. You okay?
Uh-huh.
Did you catch him?
I think I got lucky. He got away. She okay?
She's hungry.
Oh, my darling. Oh, my darling. Oh, my darling Clementine. You are lost and gone forever. Dreadful sorrow.
you're feeding her right.
I don't know about right, but we're feeding her.
Look, you want to split? Alf and me'll take care of Charlie here till Papa comes.
Well, that does put a whole different light on things.
Well, those two goons, you know, they're pretty riled up by now. Shoot, there's no telling what they might do.
You want to split, partner?
Well, I'm starting to love this place.
Well, I guess we'll stay. We're starting to love the place.
You're a mess, you two. Aren't they, Olive?
Gonna get their heads busted. That's what's gonna happen.
And you're always the ray of sunshine on a wet day, Olive.
I hear, honey bunch.
Y'all remind me of a couple of sailors I knew back in California, out of San Diego. Man, I tell you, me and them two hooped and hollered and kicked it up so much they finally had to send them out to sea. Those were the days.
Who told you? Oh. The kitten needs to go to the bathroom.
Come on. I'll take her out.
Don't go no place without me.
We won't leave without you.
Why don't we split? As soon as the old man gets back.
We don't have a load. That's why we don't split.
Well, you can always deadhead for a little while. Get a load in Atlanta.
I told you, I'm not deadheading out of here.
Man of action. Start something, you gotta stick with it till it's finished.
What did I start?
Hey, listen, I just heard. Ed is on his way in here with a couple of carloads of goons. And he's gonna come crashing through that front door and he's gonna stalk you.
Well, what do you say, partner?
Say, if you don't stop eating ice cream, you're gonna get fatter than Henny.
Didn't you hear what I said? Edney's on his way in here.
You just say that because you want it for yourself.
If I wanted my own ice cream, I'd order some.
Oh, Lord have mercy.
You better be right, guy. Better be right.
I told you to dump that rig of theirs, Junior.
Kid was inside. There was a ruckus, man. I had to split.
Stupid. You're stupid, Junior. All right. I run Pruitt and Chandler clobbered real good. And I want it done so everybody in there are going to see.
There's a lot of people in there, Mr. Edney.
That's why I'm doing it. They all saw what them two done to us. Now they're going to see what I do to them.
Go out back, make sure Charlie didn't come waltzing in here. Well, look at the new jacket.
No, I like the other one even better.
Oh, even with the clam chowder.
Better. Mm-hmm. You two pulled a real funny, didn't you? Got a good joke at my expense.
Well, not as big as the laugh we're going to get when we throw your tails out of here again.
Yeah. You know, it's a fright how anybody could be so dumb.
That's what I just said, huh?
Yeah, you did.
I mean, how could a guy like Edney hang out with a bunch of lightweight boys? That's really dumb.
I mean, it's really dumb. I mean, there've got to be 25 truckers in here, and every trucker is better than a half a dozen of those hoods.
Oh, better than a dozen?
It's dumb.
Dumb. All right, go ahead, take them.
Hey, Edney.
Yeah?
I'm with these guys.
You're out of your tree.
I know. What was that you were saying a while ago about being dumb? That's what I thought you said.
Now, what were you saying?
I'm with him, too. Alice walking Charlie. He never was much in a fight. Drives a mean truck, though. Hello, Edney.
Where's Pruitt?
Here. Hey, who is?
You Pruitt?
Yeah, that's me.
Sawyer, Joe Sawyer.
Hey, Joe, we got your little girl.
Yeah, I know, and I sure want to thank you guys. Where is she?
Well, she's safe. She's okay. Don't worry.
Hey, what's this creep doing here?
I don't know, creep. What are you doing?
All right, what are you waiting for? There's only the four of them and the fat broad here.
Five.
Six. Seven.
Eight.
Nine.
Ten.
How is it?
12.
Now, just a minute. You mean just take it easy. There's plenty of loads out there if you want them. 50 cents a mile. 38 cents if you... deadhead back. That's free and clear.
Now, just break this up, you hear?
Break it up.
This here's between me and Broad and Chandler.
It ain't like you said, Mr. Edney.
What was it he said, Will?
I think he said loads for everyone.
He's like free and clear. Yeah. Ain't that a shame? He doesn't have a right to say anything about the loads anymore. He's all through.
Just so we're going to make it an honest man out of him. Sound like Smokey? Did you call Smokey?
Me?
Hey, did you call Smokey?
Smokey gets very upset when anybody picks on truckers.
Yeah, that's what I hear.
Where's that loading depot?
98, west of Charlotte.
Machine parts for Dallas, right?
That's what the man said.
Sundan, you there?
This is Sundance, come on.
Uncle Will, Uncle Sonny.
Charlie, how are you?
I left you a present in the sleeper.
Hold on a second. Hey, that's very nice. Thanks, hon.
Thanks, Charlie.
I love you.